I'm Steve Swanson. I was on missions STS-117, 119, and then TMA-12 up to the space station on a Soyuz rocket, and where I spent Expedition 39 and 40 on the International Space Station. When I was really young, I really just wanted to live in the woods and be a mountain man. And so that's what I was planning on doing until I realized that was not a really career field there. So not great job opportunities either. So I decided I might try something different. And I've always liked science and engineering. I mean, and that's just what I like. I realized it. And so I was heading that way anyway. And after my master's, actually, in computer science, I realized that I really had to get a job, and I had to think out what job do you really want to do. And so I really spent some time pondering that question, and that's when I came up with the idea of being an astronaut. It, you know, challenged you physically, it challenged you mentally. It had adventure. It had all these other aspects to it that I thought would be really, really fun. And so I started trying at that point. You got to be a good team member. That's really, I think, the most important thing. And of course, you got to be competent in what you do. You got to be able to help out the team. It's part of being a good team member. But of course, it means you got to be a good communicator. If they're working on facilitating solutions and taking ideas from everybody and making a synthesis of those ideas and coming up with answers, that kind of thing. That whole idea of being a great team member helps, I think, tremendously. And then also just being a well-rounded person. I think that's a really overlooked trait, but that's really important. The spacewalking is a fantastic, fantastic thing you could get to do. So that's a great thing. You get to go outside, see the world from your own little spaceship. It's really wonderful. But being a robotic arm operator is also fun. You get to do different things. Fly around somebody who's doing a spacewalk. That was a good thing to do, too. It was, you never were sure you were going to go right away. Right, because you know the weather could stop you, malfunctions on the vehicle, all sorts of things like that could happen. And so the way I always approached it was like, I don't even think I'm going to go today. Even though we're getting in the vehicle to go, the odds of us going are less than 50%, say. So I wasn't ever really worried until in the time, like, well, at 9 minutes you come out of the weather hold, and that's when the weather's actually been good. Then you work your way down, and things start at 5 minutes. They move, start the auxiliary power units. And continuing down, each little step you get closer and closer because that's one less failure now that didn't happen, right? So you get closer. And by the time, at 31 seconds to go, you take over, the onboard computers take over. And at that time, that's really, and if that happens cleanly, you got a really, really high chance of going. And that's when you start thinking about, oh my God, I'm actually going to launch. And then you only have 31 seconds to actually kind of freak out. So that's But which is a good thing. But then the actual launch for me in the shuttle was I was really impressed by the initial acceleration. To me, I like to think of it as like I'm sitting, on a seat on your, laying back, and somebody has this big hydraulic press, like this big, 12-inch kind of thing, and it hits you in the back and just keeps pushing. It was just that amazing. I mean, it was a jolt off the pad. So I thought that was just fantastic. And it shakes quite, not violently is the wrong word, but quite a lot it shakes. And so much that it's even difficult to read the displays why the shuttle rocket boosters are going on. And that's like 2 minutes and 5 seconds. And so, but once they are off, it is a smooth ride. It's just, it is so smooth that you really, you feel the acceleration, you feel the heaviness, but you don't, it's just like you're just going through a glass, lake, and you're water skiing. It's just perfect. So it was really beautiful. And then main engine cutoff, and boom, you are there and floating. Well, I think the favorite part is floating, just period, because it's just a great thing. Be able to do flips and get so adapted to that environment that you feel comfortable in everything you do in there. You're so used to it. And that was a really interesting or fun thing also to do and see how well your body can adapt to something like that. But to me, the floating just made the whole thing. Everything was fun, or almost everything, but that's another subject. When we try to tell everybody, all the interesting things are going to happen to you, or things difficult too, they're going to happen to you before you get there. But there's always, you don't know the magnitude of those things when people talk to you about it. You think, oh, I'll be able to handle that, no problem, or something like that. And I think to me, the thing was most difficult was keeping track of your stuff. Because, we have Velcro over here as you look around, right? That does not really work that well. It's a poor substitute for gravity. It really is. And so, coming and just brush it by, and if you're not paying attention, that thing floats off, you're not going to find it for a while. And so it really ends up being a difficult thing to do. So that was it. You have to really figure out how you're going to be very organized and methodical about everything you do when it comes to that stuff. First of all, you got bring pictures of home. That's a great thing to do. I mean, and not just my immediate family, but all sorts of other family, my parents, everybody I could possibly do. I brought pictures and you'd take a put them against the window here and take a picture of them so they can see the Earth in the background and stuff like that. So that was, I think, a great thing to do. And it's easy because it's lightweight, but it's really personal for other people. They get to do that. All sorts of other things, though. I am a Firefly geek, a sci-fi geek, so I like Firefly. I took all the CDs for Firefly off with me, the first mission, and all that kind of stuff. So there's always little things like that you throw in there. And the last, the Soyuz one, I got on a crew care package. I got some Nerf dart guns, so we had Nerf dart gun wars, stuff like that. So it's fun. We can do all sorts of little things like that. Well, one thing is you are busy, so it does help it go by more quickly. But it is a long time to be up there and miss your family. But luckily, we had good communication with our family. So we had to do email. I could call them on a regular basis. And once a week, we would actually do a Skype session with them. So that really helped, I think. So the communication with the family was actually quite well. And I felt pretty much connected with them. So that wasn't that bad of a, even though you missed them, it wasn't like that was a tremendous deal. I think the hardest thing to keep yourself going was sometimes the food, honestly, for me. I like food and I like decent food. And so having not so decent food for a lot longer period and knowing you're not going to get any other decent food, I guess that's not for a while. That was sometimes difficult to take. And you have to figure out ways to try to make it more interesting or spice it up, so to speak. So when we finally got some sriracha sauce on board, my life was much better. I don't think it really influenced or changed my perceptions at all. I think it just affirmed them. It really came more strong how I felt about the same things, that we got to take care of our planet. We got to take care of each other, things like that. Don't be mean to each other, or back to Bill and Ted, be like excellent to one another, but that's really what we need to do. And that just, when you see the Earth from that kind of view, it brings it home for you. Science and engineering. I'm a little biased in that way, I'll admit it. But I think that's just a fantastic thing to do. And it really will help our country out if we can get strong, people in that area to do, create new things, make the world a better place by creating new, inventions, etc. I think that'd be fantastic. So we were growing the first edible food in space. And so that was my job actually to do that scientific experiment. And it was actually pretty fun. I like gardening a little bit, but I don't really do too much of it. It's not like I don't like it. I just haven't, it's some of the things I'd like to do too. But it was kind of fun to actually grow something, because it becomes yours. You have to take care of, you get ownership into it. So you really care about, every day I go check it, water it, all this kind of stuff, take pictures of it, see how it's going. And then after, I think it was 30 days, we grew it for. And it actually got big heads of lettuce. I mean, they were quite big. And so then we harvested it, so to speak. But since it was the first time that we had grown edible food on the station, the scientists were like, you can't eat it because there could be, actually they used the word space microbes. They said it could be space microbes that we don't know about. And we're like, really? But yeah, so we packaged most of it up. I'll put it that way. Maybe some of it got loose. Maybe, I don't know. Some of it might've floated in my mouth. I don't know, it could have happened. I'm again biased on this one thing. I think science is a fantastic thing because it's really how our world works. You want to know, why is the sky blue? Why is there lightning? Why does anything happen? It's all about science, right? That's really what it is. And so that's what, to me, those are the questions that always intrigued me. And so that's why I find, finding those answers out. And there's a lot of answers we just still don't have a clue on. We don't even know what 75% of our universe is made of. If we're guessing at dark energy, dark matter, but those are just guesses. We haven't really figured this all out yet. There's so many unanswered questions out there that need to be answered.